Hi, it's Katrina. From snakes who went decades without being seen alive to others who are there if you know where to look, here are 12 of the world's rarest snakes. Number 12. San Francisco Garter Snake. This colorful snake is a subspecies of the common garter snake, native to San Mateo County and the extreme northern part of coastal Santa Cruz County in California. It has been declared an endangered species since 1967, and researchers estimate that there are only about 1,000 to 2,000 members remaining. It is considered the most beautiful snake in the United States. They are quite colorful with blue-green scales and black, red, orange, and blue-green stripes. They have a red-orange head and large eyes, which gives them good eyesight during the day. Adults can reach 1 meter in length. Their favorite food is the also threatened California red-legged frog that lives in freshwater ponds and streams, so they often hang out by these aquatic areas looking for young frogs. Adult bullfrogs will actually attack the snakes and eat them too, so they have to watch out. If the frogs are too much trouble, the snakes will also eat the toxic California newt. They are one of the few animals that can eat them without suffering serious side effects. Luckily for the snake, it is hard to see and capture as they are very elusive, and many live on private property that cannot be surveyed, so it makes it harder for collectors to get to them. Even though it is illegal, they are still highly desired in the pet trade. Number 11. Ocellate Mountain Viper. Vipera wagneri, more commonly known as the Ocellate Mountain Viper, is only found in parts of eastern Turkey. German naturalist Moritz Wagner first described the species in 1846, and it wasn't seen again for 140 years. By the time scientists tracked a living specimen down in 1986, many believed it was extinct. Despite its limited geographic distribution and its nearly century-and-a-half-long hiatus from scientific scrutiny, the ocellate mountain viper population was abundant when researchers rediscovered it. Unfortunately, once word got out about the species still existing, viper collectors began grabbing up the snakes, including many pregnant females. Wildlife crime is a multi-billion-dollar business run by international networks second only to drugs and weapons on the black market. By the time biologists Goran Nilsson and Claes Andrén succeeded in banning international trading of the ocellate mountain viper without an export license, snake collectors had decimated the population to the tune of 80%. A newly constructed dam on the RAREST River further threatened the species. Today, the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species categorizes the ocellate mountain viper as critically endangered. In 2013, the St. Louis Zoo began a breeding program in an effort to save the species from the brink of extinction. While the snake's survival in the wild has not improved, the zoo's program has proven successful thus far. Number 10. Alcatraz's Lancehead. Bothrop's alcatraz, or the alcatraz's lancehead, is a critically endangered, highly venomous pit viper species that only lives on the Alcatraz's Islands, about an hour's boat ride off the coast of northern Sao Paulo in Brazil. It originated on the half-square-mile rock island of Isla de Alcatrazes after rising seawaters disconnected the territory from the mainland about 15,000 years ago. From there, the Bothrop's alcatraz evolved from the common Bothrop's genus of pit vipers due to its isolation-imposed limited diet, in a process known as allopatric speciation. The snake feeds mainly on rodents and, in times of desperation, cockroaches. Because of this, it only grows up to 20 inches long. While the alcatraz's lancehead appears to be common on the island on which it lives, its population may be declining, although the IUCN Red List currently lists it as stable, and the island's frequent use as a naval target area threatens its existence. Scientists are unsure of its exact population numbers, but seeing as it is only found here out of the entire world, you can guess there aren't very many. Number 9. Santa Catalina Island Rattlesnake. Crotalus catalinensis, better known as the Santa Catalina Island rattlesnake, is only found on Isla Santa Catalina on the Gulf of California, east of the southern Baja California Peninsula. It's a slender, medium-sized, venomous pit viper that grows to a little over 2 feet long and uniquely lacks a functioning rattle. Experts believe that this rattleless rattlesnake evolved to travel through the desert brush quietly, which prevents it from scaring away the birds it preys upon. The Santa Catalina Island rattlesnake is also different from other rattlesnake species because it moves quickly, in contrast to its slower, larger-bodied terrestrial counterparts. It also hangs onto its prey after biting, unlike most rattlesnakes. While feral cats were once a great danger to the snake, they were eradicated in 2002, but this does not preclude the species from being victimized by other species. Also, its primary prey, the deer mouse, is declining, thereby posing an additional threat to the survival of the Santa Catalina Island rattlesnake. Illegal reptile collectors are the top threat to the passive, easily captured snake. Rare snakes are consistently in high demand in the exotic pet market, and helping people catch them often proves more profitable than a week's worth of honest work. And now for number 8, but of course, I have to stop to give these people some love. Big shout out to Nicholas Blignout and Joe Morgan. Thanks so much for your nice comments. Be sure to subscribe, and if you are a new subscriber, let me know in the comments below. Number 8. Antiguan racer. Alsophis antigua, or the Antiguan racer, is only found on a handful of islands off the coast of Antigua and Barbuda, a twin island country in the eastern Caribbean. Contrary to its deceptive name, the Antiguan racer is a slow-moving ambush predator who preys on lizards and is harmless to humans. The species declined dramatically following the 19th century arrival of invasive rats and mongooses. The Antiguan racer population hit an all-time low of 50 in 1995, when its geographic distribution was limited to Great Bird Island off the northeast Antiguan coast. This seemingly dismal news provided renewed hope to researchers, as the species had been falsely declared extinct in 1936. Flora and Fauna International seized the opportunity to save the Antiguan racer by partnering with other organizations. Together, they focused on eliminating invasive populations, protecting sensitive ecosystems, and changing negative attitudes towards snakes by educating people about them. While the Antiguan racer is still considered critically endangered, conservationists have restored its population 22-fold to over 1,100 specimens. Number 7. Derevsky's viper. Vipera derevsky, or Derevsky's viper, is a small venomous snake endemic to northwestern Armenia, northeastern Turkey, and possibly Georgia. It's named after Russian zoologist and herpetologist Ilya Derevsky, who was among the first researchers to find and describe the species. While the viper's bite is painful and causes swelling, it's generally non-life-threatening to humans. It preys on lizards, small rodents, and insects, and has a very fast digestive system, and therefore needs a lot of food. The Derevsky's viper population is decreasing and critically endangered, according to the IUCN Red List, with a last known population numbering around 500. It's primarily threatened by overgrazing of vegetation by domestic sheep and cattle in its restricted habitat. Thankfully, the species is protected under Armenian law and is therefore not at the mercy of the international pet trade, in theory. While there is a clear necessity to protect this species through conservation efforts, not much seems to be going on in this department. Number 6. Round Island Boa. Casaraea ducemieri, or the round island keel-scaled boa, is a non-venomous snake species endemic to the uninhabited islet of Round Island Mauritius, an island nation located in the Indian Ocean. It gets its common name from the small, keeled scales covering its body. The most unique feature of the round island boa is its split jaw, which is an anomaly among extant terrestrial vertebrates. This is likely an evolutionary adaptation that provides the species with an advantage in catching its preferred prey of geckos and skinks. The IUCN Red List classifies the round island boa as endangered, meaning that it faces a long-term risk of extinction in the wild. In 1996, the species' estimated population plummeted to less than 250 mature specimens. Thanks to conservation efforts, the round island boa has revived to a population of roughly 1,000. By eradicating invasive species like goats and rabbits, conservationists have helped to restore the natural habitat and availability of prey. A captive breeding program has also helped save the round island boa from the brink of extinction and ensured its continued survival. Number 5. Orlov's viper. Vipera orlovi, or the Orlov's viper, is a medium-sized venomous viper native to Russia's Black Sea coastal region and endemic to the Caucasus region. It wasn't until 2001 that the species was distinguished from its close relative, the Caucasian viper. This extremely rare snake has a triangular head, long fangs, and varying colors and patterns, which typically range from brown to gray and yellow-gray. It feasts on a wide variety of prey, including mice, lizards, insects, and frogs. There are an estimated 250 or less Orlov's vipers living in the wild. The overcollection of snakes for the exotic pet trade is the number one threat to the critically endangered species. Additionally, the Orlov's viper's remaining natural habitat consists of less than 38 square miles or 100 square kilometers. Number 4. Aruba Island Rattlesnake. Crotalus unicolor, otherwise known as the Aruba Island rattlesnake, is a moderately sized venomous pit viper. There's a lot of pit vipers on this list. It's exclusive to the Caribbean island of Aruba, which is located about 18 miles north of the Venezuelan coast. It's typically gray or light brown in color and grows up to 35 inches long. Unlike many other snakes, the Aruba Island rattlesnake is viviparous, meaning it gives birth to live young as opposed to laying eggs. Its diet consists primarily of rodents, birds, and lizards. There are an estimated 230 adult specimens living in the wild, due partially to the snake's extremely limited geographic range, which humans are increasingly encroaching upon. The undeveloped habitat available to the Aruba Island rattlesnake constitutes a roughly 9.5 square mile space, or 25 square kilometer space. Invasive goats in Aruba also impact the species' decline. Exporting the critically endangered Aruba Island rattlesnake is illegal, but it's also not afforded much legal protection. Thankfully, wildlife organizations and the Aruba government have taken it upon themselves to rescue the species through captive breeding programs, as well as the designation of Arikok National Park during the early 1980s as a refuge for the snake. Government outreach also focuses on changing the much maligned views of snakes by promoting the creature as a national symbol of economic and ecological importance. Number 3. Cropan's boa. Corallus cropani, also known as Cropan's boa, is a non-venomous, elusive tree boa endemic to the 116-square-mile Atlantic forest of São Paulo, Brazil. It's one of the world's rarest boas. Cropan's boa was discovered and first described in 1953. It would be another 64 years until researchers observed one alive and well. In the meantime, they relied upon a collection of 5 dead specimens to learn about the species. Finally, in 2017, residents of the rural Ribeira Valley region presented scientists with the second living Cropan's boa ever seen. The snake was a female measuring 5.6 feet long with a weight of 3.3 pounds. The coordinated efforts between locals and researchers resulted from extensive outreach on behalf of the Museum of Zoology of the University of São Paulo and the Butantan Institute. Scientists tagged the specimen and released her back into the wild so they could learn more about the species' behavior. So far, they've determined that the snake is arboreal, meaning it lives among the trees. It probably dines mainly on birds and small mammals. Through the program, scientists encouraged local residents to help them learn more about the Cropan's boa's habitats by teaching them about its ecological value. Without this collaborative effort, it's unlikely that scientists would have gained access to a live specimen. In fact, one of the boa's captors nearly hacked her to death, but thought twice when two others remembered recently seeing the researchers' wanted signs for a live snake. Cropan's boa is threatened mainly by its limited endemic region. At one time, the Atlantic forest occupied between 386,000 and 580,000 square miles. Between 90 and 98% of that habitat has been destroyed by human activity, primarily the clearing of land for agricultural purposes. Number 2. The short-nosed sea snake. The short-nosed sea snake, also known as the Sahul reef snake, occupies an estimated combined area of 3.86 square miles in the Ashmore and Hibernia reefs off the northwestern Australian coast. It's slender with a short head and pointed snout and grows up to 60 centimeters long and typically dwells in waters exceeding 10 meters in depth. This species was somewhat abundant into the 90s, but is rapidly declining. The last known sighting of a short-nosed sea snake was in the year 2000. Researchers have not pinpointed a primary cause for the species' endangerment, as there are no distinguishable current or future threats, but they suspect that rising ocean temperatures and the subsequent bleaching of coral reefs play a role. The short-nosed sea snake's temperature tolerance is thought to max out at about 36 degrees Celsius or 96.8 degrees Fahrenheit, and it's quite possible that its habitat's waters are warmer than that. The accidental capture of sea snakes by commercial fishers is also thought to contribute to the short-nosed sea snake's apparent demise. There are no known plans to try saving the species, as it already dwells partially within a protected nature reserve, and there's already a marine bioregional plan in place for the area. Number 1. Saint Lucia Racer. While researchers are still learning about Liophis ornatus, or the Saint Lucia racer, also called the ornate ground snake, they know that it's non-venomous, diurnal, which means it is active during the day, that it eats lizards, and that it grows up to 48.6 inches. The Saint Lucia racer is the world's most endangered snake species. It's endemic to the Eastern Caribbean island nation of Saint Lucia, and its remaining mature population numbers between just 8 and 49 specimens, according to a 2015 IUCN Red List assessment. The species nearly disappeared following the introduction of non-native mongooses into the environment during the 19th century. It was declared extinct in 1936 and was rediscovered in 1973, only to disappear yet again shortly thereafter. In 2012, 18 of the snakes were discovered on the island of Maria Major off the southeastern coast of Saint Lucia. Other ongoing threats to the species' existence include agriculture, aquaculture, the raising of aquatic animals and/or plants for food, and severe weather such as storms and flooding. Conservationists with the international conservation charity Fauna and Flora International are currently trying to prevent the Saint Lucia racer from going extinct. Thanks for watching! Which snake did you like the most? What other exotic creatures would you like to learn about? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe if you haven't already! See you next time! Bye!